And I'm now joined here in the studio by Jonh from Streamline Taxis and George, who represents independent drivers in the city. Together, they represent over 90% of the licensed taxi drivers in Brighton and Hove. Thanks for joining me, gentlemen.
Thank you very much.
So we're here to talk about the, well, really an ongoing process that you've been going through for a number of years now. How has it been fighting Uber?
Well, keeps you sane. we had a protest in Lewes at the beginning of the week on Monday, yep, which was very successful. We had over 100 cars turn up. We closed the town down for over an hour. This was to bring to the public's attention in Lewes what their council are doing, which is they're gaining cash by giving out licences to private hire drivers that have got no intention whatsoever of working in the Lewes district area.
Okay.
In fact, predominantly coming over and working in the Brighton area. In Brighton, I'm not sure if you're aware, but we've got several areas in the city centre that are exceeding the EU guidelines for pollution levels.
Yep, absolutely.
So with the increase of volume of traffic, this is not helping Brighton
anybody.
City Council's,
yeah,
need to bring these levels down. Also, a lot of these drivers, once they're getting the private hire plates on the back of the car, they're removing them as soon as they drive away and come into our district. This is presenting a public safety issue.
Absolutely.
Which we felt it was necessary to bring to light.
Definitely. Jonh, could you please compare for me the difference between getting a licence here in Brighton and getting a licence in Lewes?
It's much more involved in Brighton. You know, our standards in Brighton are, on a scale out of 10, are probably 9.5 out of 10. Somewhere like Lewes, they can go online, they can get a licence very easy. But the most important thing, and it's not about competition, this is public safety and a level playing field. And we resent the fact that Lewes, on our adjacent licensing area, they gave Uber a 5-year private hire operator's licence last year.
Okay.
Just like that. Now, in Brighton, we've been, I wouldn't say more vocal, we've been more objectionable,
yeah,
because they're not complying with the... They gave a verbal commitment in October 2015 at the public inquiry. Their legal advisers in Brighton Town Hall said, if you give us a private hire operator's licence, we will only use drivers and vehicles licensed by Brighton Hove City Council. They've never kept to that, and this has been the problem. Within 6 to 9 months of that licence being issued, they've started bringing down Transport for London licensed drivers, and the town has been inundated. The problem you've got there, the only people that can enforce the vehicles and the drivers that operate in Brighton, licensed elsewhere, is actually the licensing authority that licensed them in the first place. So consequently, our Hackney Carriage Office down here, we're quite active in that respect, even though they're understaffed. They're quite active. They cannot look at Transport for London vehicles no more, yeah, than they can look at Lewes licensed vehicles that are on our doorstep. This is a problem we've got. This is a time bomb here waiting to happen. And Lewes is adding to this problem. And from the 14th of March, Uber have said they will not dispatch any work via their app to Transport for London vehicles operating in Brighton, which is fine. But what they're doing on their website, they're now sending their drivers over to Lewes to get a private hire operator's licence, and they will be dispatching work to them.
And it's not just Lewes, sorry to cut you off there, Jonh, yeah, but it's not just Lewes, is it? It's to get a scale of where this is happening and how far taxis are coming from. Whereabouts have you seen, like,
We've constantly got guys that are from Sefton, which, if you don't know where Sefton is, it's in Liverpool.
Liverpool.
Yeah, and they've been down here. They've been down here constantly for over a year now.
Wow.
It's over a year. So we're now, we're coming into the weekend.
And sorry, does some of these drivers, they're coming from Liverpool, where are they staying? What are they doing?
Oh, they've recently found a B&B, but that's taken them 8 or 9 months. They've been sleeping in the backs of their cars for
We've got photos of them sleeping in their cars.
Really? Wow.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And this is just sort of the workforce that Uber is really promoting and really encouraging,
is.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
You mentioned earlier that they're ushering drivers towards Lewes to get this easier license.
Their own website is referring them to Lewes to work in Brighton. And this is what we're concerned about. We've overcome, hopefully from the 14th of March, one problem, but there again, it's down to enforcement. Lewes cannot go on indefinitely licensing these drivers without having enforcement officers in place to come into Brighton and Hove and to oversee them. And the bottom line also with Lewes is their Hackney carriages. Now, there's a different legislation between Hackney carriages and private hire vehicles. Now, you've got Hackney carriages coming into Brighton with Lewes. Now, they're Hackney carriage 24/7, but when they operate outside their own licensing area, they become private hire, but they still have to have the roof signs on. Now, only this morning I've got sent a photo of a Lewes Hackney in Brighton yesterday without a roof sign. Lewes Council have got a lot to answer for. We've asked questions, and if we're going to freedom of information, if they don't supply it, but they really need to look at why they...
We're sort of running out of time now, but just to hear from both of you, to conclude the discussion here, what would you like to see happen from the council? What needs to happen?
I'd like Lewes to be a little bit more answerable. They keep saying that they're just following the guidelines. If they look at their local government authority handbook, they could see that there is a paragraph on page 23 stating that they can withhold private hire licences if the driver's not intending to work within the district.
OK, thanks, George. Sorry, John, we're going to have to wrap it up now. We've completely run out of time, but thank you very much for joining us.